In this video, we'll take a closer look at firms in monopolistically competitive markets. The focus will be on firms earning supernormal profits in the short run and understanding why they cannot maintain them in the long run. To understand why, let's take a look at a sample firm. Imagine a firm produces dishwashing liquid and decides to expand its product offering and launches a new blueberry washing liquid. The product is an instant hit with consumers and demand levels are so high that the firm starts to earn a supernormal profit. Here's what that would look like in the short run. We lay out demand and marginal revenue as before, but something unique happens here. The profit maximizing level of output, Q star, results in a price that is higher than the average costs at this point. The result is total revenue, which is greater than total costs. This allows the firm to earn supernormal profits. That's not the end of the story. Remember, there are low barriers to entry in monopolistically competitive markets, so other firms would be lured in by the supernormal profits being earned. This is the previous firm's cost and revenue diagram. As new firms enter the market, the demand for this firm's products will fall. This is because its customers are now taking their business elsewhere, causing this specific firm to face a fall in demand. What will happen next is that demand will keep falling until the firm is earning normal profit. As a firm is now earning normal profit, entering the market is no longer attractive. At this point, the firm can continue to sell the product, but does not earn any supernormal profit. That wraps up this video on monopolistically competitive firms earning supernormal profits in the short run. You should understand why a firm in this structure cannot maintain supernormal profits, and also be familiar with how to draw both short-run and long-run equilibrium. Leave any questions or comments below, and I will see you in the next one.